May 2011. We're driving home. Happy. But exhausted. Covered in ash. We had spent the entire day in a burnt, soot-covered forest. Our daughter's in the back of our VW-like van, blissfully serenading the piles of mushrooms that were all around her. We had literally $1,000 worth of wild mushrooms we picked that day. A real treasure that we only shared with the dearest of friends, but continued to deliciously dine on for a year to come. This was one of the most magical immersions into the wonderful world of mushroom picking, of which, here in southern Alberta, the season has just begun. And as it always does, it started off with Morcha, more commonly known as the morel. In some parts, it's known as the May mushroom, because it often comes out in May. Morcella esculenta is the Latin name. Esculenta means edible. It's not just edible, it's delicious. And you don't have to go into burnt forests to find them. They grow in fields, forests, river valleys, and gardens. Best to take a basket with you, because as you find these little treasures, you want to have your little mushroom knife. You find one, you cut it right at the base, you put it in your basket, you begin your collection. These little mushroom knives also have a handy dandy brush, so you can brush off any leaves, dirt, whatever it may be. As you can see, this here is what's known as yellow morel, or golden morel. There are in fact over 70 different varieties. The black morel, the yellow morel. They range, on average, about the size of your thumb. However, some of them can get as tall as your hand. It's no easy feat finding these morels. Especially in the spring, where you have last year's leaves that litter the ground, and pine cones. You'll be searching, 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 and just when you think you found one, it's another leaf. I've spent hours to find none, and then lo and behold, you find one. As my wife says, it's a boost of your morale to find a morel. Every year I search for morel mushrooms, I intuitively get the sense of when they're out. According to folklore, when the Saskatoon blooms, you can find these shrooms. The conditions are right. We've just had some rain, now the sun is out. I know they're out there. On Friday night, I got a text, a picture, with the words, edible? Question mark? I reply, yeah, best thing you do is, just pick as many as you can and bring them to me. You're not going to like them. If you're lucky, they will come up in abundance the first year after a fire. And that May day back in 2011, we collected over 50 pounds. And if you have more than you can eat, fresh, over a couple of days, best is to dry them. But don't do what I did, which was to stuff my dehydrator full of as many morels as I could and crank the heat on. A couple hours later, I came back. The entire thing was covered in spore. This is like the seed of a mushroom. It was this white, fine powder that was caked on thick every inch and corner of that dehydrator. Best I found is to string them, kind of like a garland, as you would popcorn in the seasonal times. Makes a wonderful, delicious, edible decoration. However, like most mushrooms, you do still need to cook them. On Sunday, I get another text from a different friend. The words, is this a morel? Question mark. I said, yeah, but you know these ones are poisonous. They contain a mild toxin that when you consume them could cause severe stomach upset. Best thing you do is gather a as many as you can. Bring them to me. I'll take care of them. What I didn't tell her was that this little poison is easily deactivated by a simple cooking. In fact, it makes them delicious. They are easily one of my favorite mushrooms. Not only because of the flavor, but because of the fun of going out and finding them. My wife likes to relate morel mushroom picking. It's like a giant Easter egg hunt extravaganza. You become a child again. You're in the forest, playful looking, especially in those burn zones where you're climbing over logs and you're just mushroom after mushroom after mushroom after mushroom. So remember, each year when the Saskatoon blooms, you can find these shrooms. And I encourage you to go out and hunt them. They are one of the most easily recognized and delicious of fungi. Morchella esculenta, the edible morel.